So, with the help of this story, actually, writer wants to say that there are many things come in our life journey also. Sometimes we have seen the greenery means the richness, love, and care, all that things. And sometimes what happens, there is nothing in our life. So the writer compare with that thing with the barren land. So now the bus reached an area which did not have the trees. It was barren land with a few shops here and there. It crossed a small settlement and the shop by the road. As the bus went with the high speed, Valley thought that it would swallow the oncoming vehicles and pedestrian, but it passed safely, crossing all hurdles. When the bus was moving, it seemed as if trees were rushing towards the bus and would stop as soon as the bus reached them. As the bus crossed them, it appeared as if the trees were running away from the bus. This thing happens with us also when we are too small. What we are thinking that the when we are seeing the bus from the bus that is the trees are also running. So what we thought that the trees are running with our bus, the vehicles are running with our bus. At the evening time or in the night when we see the moon, then what we have thought that moon is coming with us with our bus. It is also traveling. So the same thing the valley is also thinking at that time. Valley was filled with his happiness and joy. Suddenly, a cow came running in the middle of the road, right in front of the bus. The bus slowed down to give her way and honked repeatedly. Unfortunately, it became more terrified and ran in front of the bus. As the driver blew more horn, the cow became wild and kept on running faster and faster. Valley found the cow incidentally extremely humorous and laughed to an extent that brought tears in her eyes. Again, the conductor teased her by telling her that it was enough for a day and she could save some laughter for the next day. Somehow, the cow went off the road on its own and the bus stopped at the level crossing from where the train was visible and the tiny dots. As the train came nearer, it grew larger. So the train passed with a huge roar, thus shaking the entire road and the bus along with it. The bus started moving and reaching the narrow street on taking the turns. It reached the wider road. There were big and brightly little shops on the road that display merchandise of for sales. Valley was attracted towards all the lights and the decoration. She glanced at each and everything because before this ride, she never left her village. So that is why she never come out from her village. So first time she had seen the city, the town where the many things are there, the lights are there, all that things are there. So she feels so enjoyable at that time. The bus arrived at the destination and everyone except Valley deboarded the bus. The conductor informed her that this was the last stop and just then she took out another 30 paisa from her pocket to buy the ticket back to village. She expressed that she only intended to take the bus ride and upon being asked to wander nearby, she told him that she was too afraid of that. Conductor, while maintaining his nature all throughout the journey, replied by saying that she wasn't afraid to travel alone in the bus without anyone's help. To this, Valley replied confidently, as far as the bus ride was concerned, there was nothing to be afraid in that. So the conductor asked her if she wished to have a drink at the nearby stall, or if he could bring her a drink if he was afraid to go out of the bus. But Valley told her that she did not have enough money. The conductor insisted to be on it being his treat, but Valley denied, and both of them waited for a new set of passengers to board. This time too, there were fewer passengers are there in the bus because evening time is there. So in the olden days, people are not much like to go in the evening from here to there. So concerned about the valley, the conductor asked if her mother would be looking for her as she was all alone. Well, Valley instantly replied by saying that no one was waiting on her because whatever the time she has taken at that time, her mother was sleeping at home in the afternoon. She knows very well that every day her mother was sleeping, and before her, her mother was awake, before that she will reach the village. So that is why she said that no one is waiting for me at home. So the return journey began to Valley was just as excited as the first time. She was looking at everything enthusiastically when she suddenly noticed the cow lying dead by the roadside. It must have been hit by a fast-moving vehicle. Valley confirmed with the dock conductor that it was the same cow they had been seen earlier. Her mood experienced and shifted towards the sadness. She wondered how a lovable and playful creature instantly transformed into the horrible and lifeless one.